Hey, love. Love's not far away. Reaching out through the ethers, calling for comfort. That's what love does, man. Love will call you. Might be a big jump, you know? Might be Tulum to Venice Beach. Might be London to Morocco. Who knows? But reach out through the ethers and call for comfort. It's time. It's time also for the I Ching. The I Ching for the week of July 10th, 2017. Yeah. Here it goes, you know what I mean? Here it goes. Number 11, Tai. Above Kun, the center of the earth. That's what's above. Below is heaven, spirit power. The wisdom. Correct connections will be made. It is the time. Heaven and earth are joining. Intuition is your guiding light. That's it, you see? There are times, it happens when we're in meditation, in prayer, in making love, and being who we are, on really finding that place within ourselves and within our heart that heaven and earth are joining. And that is one of the roles of being a human being on this earth. We are the ones to bring heaven and earth together, right? We want to create a new Eden. We want to make it good. Well, that's the job. Bring heaven and earth together. Start with you. Start with your world. Start with your community. Start with the ones that you love. Huh? Reach out. That haiku means something to me. Love's not far away. Reaching out through the ethers, calling for comfort. Yeah. Make a long reach, ocean to ocean, heart to heart, country to country, world to world. The wisdom this week is correct connections will be made because it's the time. Heaven and earth are joining. Intuition is your guiding light. A clear message comes. This message we get from this hexagram is in support of your journey toward completion, toward satisfaction. You've been asking yourself, and rightly so, why, when you've been diligent with great effort, have you not made the advancement you've been working for, the ones you've desired? The hexagram that comes to us this week to tell you that you are now in a position, you can attract a great overflowing of energy that with correct intention and proper behavior is going to be for you, it's yours, because all that you've been working on and all that you've sacrificed along the way have made way for this energy flow. And it's going to be big. In some cases, it might even be jarring in its intensity. You'll have to be proactive. You'll have to be aware and awake to harness and use this energy to make connections, to complete tasks, to discern your allies. Who are they? And who are your detractors? Embrace your allies, whether they're near or far, and dismiss the detractors. Ferret out the ones in your sphere whom you must constantly pull up to your level and dismiss them. Might be a friend, a lover, associate, a relative, but man, that's not the job. Our place is to hold our place and to be met. The flattering attention they may have offered is without foundation, and you'll ultimately be draining yourself, and it'll be destructive. It'll be an obstacle. You're entering a new time of connectivity that can open the channels for true and continuing abundance at last. This oncoming force, imbued with spirit, can now neutralize the lingering doubts about yourself and your life's work. Doubts, fears that have wakened you in the middle of the night and greeted you first thing in the morning. That's the time we're going to let them go. The worry that you didn't have it together in the parts and places that mattered most, and that your past decisions were flawed, you're hearing that word? Well, that's not justified. Dig it. You were simply engaged. You were focusing on keeping your ship afloat, and that's all right. accept the truth that you've been on your own inner journey, a journey of preparation, and you've been making the best decisions you could in the face of your emotional and your financial, maybe, survival. It's true. You've been self-absorbed. Big deal. No blame. That comes with the territory. When we're preparing to make great advancements in our relationship with self, our art, and commerce, the ego would come and have you think that you've been off track in your thoughts and actions, and that it was this keeping you from reaching your goals. But this isn't true. Not true at all. This is only the distracting voice of the inner critic yapping in judgment of your process. This time of prospering has been activated by your inner wisdom, slowing things down and giving you time through the tempering fire of adversity to develop strength of intuition, strength of purpose. And now as you call from within for guidance to bring forth clarity, you'll be placed in the correct frequency, which will propel you toward the best and the highest good. The highest good for yourself in career, in relationships, and for the greater good. Greater good for your tribe, your family, for yourself. Often we get advised and feel the need to go and see the sage, to go see the wise person in the tribe, or go visit the shaman, do the medicine sometimes. Well, this is not the time. This is the time to use and depend on your own wisdom and intuitive powers, which you've been developing while you were being diligent on your path of healing, your spiritual advancement, your creativity. With proper intention and by initiating creative ritual, your vision, your plans, and desires will be made manifest and brought to life. Be mindful and have crystal clear knowledge of your intentions as to what you want to do or create as this incredible surge of life force comes your way. Prepare with the body, with the mind, with the spirit, and this will allow you to activate the incredible, dignified, and compassionate being that you truly are. Then seal the deal with sacred ritual. During these times of preparation, direct your energy pointedly for yours and for the greater good. Use this life force to activate what you want. Don't squander your energy. Focus it. Choose your target and go for it. Focus, don't scatter shoot, hoping that one arrow out of many will surely hit the mark. It doesn't work that way. By using your intuition to choose the point, and then to aim, and then to move, with all your skill and intention toward the goal, that's the work. That's the arrow. Your career, your spiritual and inner emotional life can flourish now. Just use your visualization, visualize success, visualize satisfaction, visualize peace of mind. Visualize what you want and you desire and what you deserve. See yourself in your power, working with joy in all areas of your life. It works. You see, this is an auspicious time for creative projects and for organizations that are working for the greater good. Anyone who's not working for the greater good or for the good of a project or endeavor will be revealed. And they must be removed from your sphere. As this occurs, do not be concerned, as this leaves space for the angels to enter or to return after standing in the wings, watching and loving you. Through that, this heavenly dance, this angelic spirit dance, your companions of destiny will emerge, and the situations and world you're creatively imagining and working toward will manifest. Honor the ones who have given you strength and with sacrifice and integrity have left you space to grow, space to create. This has been a great gift for yourself, for your confidence, a confidence that will be relished by you as the arrival of abundance in your career comes. Your health, your love, it's all going to grow now. You can do it. This is the time. Things are in order. Trust it. Your sexual energy and your sexual attraction and your sensuality are part and parcel of this oncoming tide of creativity. Be very sensitive as you ride this wave. Spread through your love, your kindness and compassion, and your laughter, this sexual energy. You know, sexual energy does not mean necessarily intercourse, but it is this way that we combine with the others. This is called Shakti. the primordial cosmic energy and divine feminine flow of creative power. Shakti, she's healing and can enliven your progress toward a happy, toward a successful and a peaceful outcome. Avoid temptation, the ones at which can be great, to use this powerful energy through seduction or inferred promises to manipulate others to achieve your goals. Don't do it. Doing so would muddy the waters and take you out of your integrity. Your dreams would be diluted or they would dissolve. And you would miss this time of completion, this time of abundance. And above all, man, just break the old habits. Look at the old ways of thinking that have controlled you and move beyond them. The confidence necessary to take you to the heights, to seek that you wish for, where you want your confidence as you move with the knowing that you've shown strength of character and you've had integrity through times of want, sacrifice, and obstruction. Your community and associates in your craft or commerce will now see you in this light of strength, of self-assurance, and will be of a support to you, will be of service to you. Those who've judged you will fade into the woodwork and will have no influence whatsoever on you, on your work, or your advancement. This does not mean, however, that the forces that were impeding your progress in the past have left the building. They've not. They've been made impotent by your work, but they're still there, lurking in the shadows, fully capable of rising up again should you fall out of your integrity. So to maintain the influences of Dai, this hexagram, appreciate how you got here and how hard you've worked to consciously join in the flow of blessings and abundance. Be generous with your joy, with your love. Take nothing for granted. Do not delude yourself into thinking that because you're entering a time of success and a time of abundance, you've completed your tasks and need not to be aware. You don't have to be aware, it says. Don't have to be awake. Well, man, that's not true. It's the opposite. You must be firmly on your path, awake, and move with a righteous knowing. As you break through and have all of this stuff rolling towards you, all this beauty, all this abundance, all this light, this feeling of comfort, man, it's just the beginning and it gets better and it gets better. Have discipline. Do your practice. Do your yoga, your Tai Chi, your meditation, whatever it is that gives you strength. Peace of mind, peace and stillness. Walk to the top of Freiman, man. Look over the world. Look for that mountain in Tibet. Walk to it. Whatever it is, man, do your ritual. Set firmly your intentions now. Be a fierce warrior. As you proceed in truth and dignity from this position, you'll soon find yourself sitting in the place of success and honor. As you sit at the table of abundance that's been set for you. Yeah. Maitre D has called your name. Table for two, right this way. Yeah, you can do it. So reach out. Maybe it's from the beaches in Tulum to the beaches in Venice Beach, who knows? I've done that. Love's not far away, reaching out through the ethers, calling for comfort, yeah. It's okay. You're in the right place, at the right time, doing the right thing. Embrace it. Clean the desk. Clean the mind. Open the heart. Namaste, my brothers. Namaste, my sisters. Sending you all the love that I can muster from down here at the 20th parallel. Hugs and love. In La Kesha La Kin. I am the other you. And yeah, I like it that way. Have a blessed week. In La Keshe Alakim. Namaste.